Separator for Mary's Milk Monsters, and today I'm going to show you how to make goat's milk cream. With these two big pots of fresh pasteurized goat milk and this cream separator, and hopefully we can turn it into lots of other yummy things. So let's get started. You need to assemble our cream separator, which is in a bunch of pieces, so that we can clean it. Start with this. This is our base, which goes on top of the motor. And if you want to get this cream separator for yourself, you can find it online. It was pretty easy to track down. And then we have this rubber, sometimes a bit temperamental. And we have our rings. And that curves through and actually helps separate it. Fasten it on the top. As tight as we can. With our special wrench that came with. Okay. And then we put that on here. Now, that was one of the most complicated parts of it. And then we have the easy part, which is where the skim comes out and where the cream comes out. And then this goes into the bowl, regulates the flow, and this also regulates the flow of the milk, along with that, into the machine. So, now that we have that all set up, another important thing to note is the temperature of the milk going in. This here is some pasteurized milk, which, to skin off, so that's gross, is 104 degrees on that pot. We have two pots because our goats were good. Pick off the skin so I could gum up water. That's about 103. Now, I find that the machine has problems if the milk is over 109 degrees, so you want to keep that in mind. Now, personally right now, we don't have a use for the skim, so we just pour it back into the pot. And we make ice cream and butter and all kinds of lovely things. Cream, which will go in there. So now that we have it all set up, I have to warn you and rip headphone users because this will be really loud, but hey, that's the price that we have to pay for all of the ice cream and butter and whipped cream and whatever else you put cream in. Now, this usually requires a little weight in it, so I'm going to dip one of the pots and then not pour it in. Simply just set it in to weigh it down. Because sometimes I can set it up perfectly and it'll not start perfectly because it's a little bit old, but I've been there. This is also electric, so just flip, switch. Yeah. because I'm hoping to film it and you guys will see it all hopefully. Anyway, thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe and all that stuff. And I will see you guys in the next video.